the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible.
Committee will please come to order. Do we have a brief question in accordance with Chapter 551 of the Texas Government Code as amended, known as the Texas Open Meetings Act?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. At this time, members of the public who wish to speak shall each have 5 minutes to address the court. Is there anyone that would like to address the court this morning? If not, we'll go to item number one to approve the minutes of April 5th meeting.
On number six and second page.
Yes, sir.
I didn't vote either way on that.
Okay.
And that changed, I made a motion to approve the minutes.
So the motion is to approve the minutes with that change. With the change to number six. All favor aye?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Who said that? I'm sorry. Who said it? Thank you.
I would like for us to request that we have on the minutes a little, kind of a little synopsis of what the discussion was, maybe a little more information about what we talked about in court.
Yes, ma'am, I'd be glad to.
Doesn't have to be in great detail, but some of the highlights about what the discussion was. Item number two is budget transfers and amendments.
I have provided the court with two listings for this week. One for budget line item transfers, and I have highlighted for you the one contingency transfer request. Also, a budget amendment for the donation to Precinct 1 for $600 so that Commissioner Bonner may spend his $600 in this budget year out of the special budget fund. The certification, the revenue certification that goes with that particular amendment has already been given to the county clerk.
Discussion on budget transfers and amendments.
I make a motion that we approve the budget transfer amendment.
I second.
All favor aye?
Aye.
Any opposed? None. Motion carried. Item number three is to approve and pay the bills. services. I have a report from the county clerk. I have also a personnel status summary as of April 13th. Are there any other reports?
Also put up there my quarterly vacation and sick leave report, put a copy up there for all of you.
Yes. And report for sick time, vacation time, comp time, and holiday time.
And Judge, may I elaborate a little bit on that personnel summary report? That's typically been on that front sheet, cover sheet of my payroll register. And a while back, the judge and I had a conversation about reviewing payroll. It's not really an action item because payroll has been set at budget time. So to sign off on it is really a moot point because it's already, first of all, it's already after the fact. This is a April 13th payroll. And the commissioners have approved that via approving the budget, they approved the number of positions and what we're going to pay for those positions. Throughout the year, if we have someone that's going to make a change, like when the sheriff took office and he comes to commissioner's court, there's another action item, you know, to change anything on payroll. So another piece of the puzzle is that the contents, the detailed contents in that payroll register that includes individuals' personal elections. It's a voluntary contract between them and another vendor, like we have tax levies, student loans, child support, extra contributions to the retirement system through a 457 plan, choosing your own election for personal policies that really don't have anything to do with the county other than we just do a payroll deduction. Those are not open records. So that's why I haven't ever recorded the entire register, just that front sheet. Now, let me back up. The way I look at this, this is your meeting. We're just here as spectators. So any more detail that you want other than what I give you, I'm happy to do it. I'm, you know, just giving you information so that you have more input or more idea of what's going on in the county. So it's up to y'all. If y'all like that status report, I just created a new one and kind of listed the number of budgeted positions that were approved, the number that's open. Some people have permanent part-time positions. Some people have, it varies, they have a limited amount of part-time. So whatever the court desires, I'm happy to furnish that information. But our conversation, the judge and I, we didn't see really any point in you having to sign off on a payroll register when there really was no action item on it and it's already been approved. So,
and we had that discussion a long time ago.
Right, and then when the auditor started giving her accounts payable report, that's an action item. You make a motion on that, so that is signing off on it, kind of, by making a motion to approve it. But payroll's been approved, it's all, you know, after the fact. So I can also, I can't give you the contents of the register, but I can give you a back sheet that just is a summary of the totals, if anybody's interested in seeing that every time.
I'm fine with this status report. I don't know if anybody else is, but.
And if you have any questions about it, this is just something, a spreadsheet that I just did for this court, and if you don't, if you want something more on it, or if you think it's overkill and it's got too much on it, I'm happy to change it, but just let me know.
Any other reports?
Yes, ma'am. The first fire department's going to be fire department. We received all the paperwork for the get the title transfer done on the truck. We haven't gotten a reimbursement check in yet. We'll give that to the auditor who needs it today. As far as the department goes, our call volume is up. The call volumes are increasing from most of the departments in the county. It seems like they're increasing. So just give you, at the end of the first quarter, we were at 8. And that's on the pace for over 300 if it continues like that. It's over the last 2 years, it's gone up steadily. So just report there.
We'll be discussing the burn ban in a few minutes, and I guess we'll ask you about that then.
Okay.
Okay.
Has all of the grant paperwork been completed and turned in so that all we're doing now is waiting on a check?
Yes, yes.
That's good.
I looked this morning, and we haven't got it yet.
Anything else?
I'm making a motion to approve.
To accept.
Accept.
Second.
I have a motion to accept the reports. All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? None. Motion carried. Item number five is to accept a $750 donation in ammunition for the deputy qualifications at the sheriff's office.
Obviously, this is a great donation that we're about to get here if y'all approve it. Chief Deputy has acquired 1,500 rounds of ammunition, of 40 caliber ammunition, which is what we use. And he's wanting to donate that to the sheriff's office at the value of $750 worth of ammo for us to use in our qualifications that we'll be having here in the next 2 to 3 months. So if y'all will accept that, and I personally thank the chief for the work he did on getting that.
And the motion will be to accept the ammunition.
It's the actual ammunition.
To accept the ammunition for the qualifications.
I make that motion to accept the ammunition for the deputy qualification at the sheriff's office. A second.
There's a motion and a second. All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? None. Motion carried. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Ben.
Item number six, to discuss interlocal agreement with Falls County regarding housing inmates as a secondary option at this time.
Yes. We ran into an issue 3 weeks ago, and there were just 2 beds left in Limestone County because they're housing for more than just us, basically like McLennan County. And it got me thinking, we're going to have a backup plan if something happens, because if we would have had 3 or 4 people on the floor, we would have had to get them over there. It would have been an option. I might have been able to get 2 there for the 2 open beds, and I would have had to do something else with the other 2. So we're just looking at a backup plan in case something arises like that again, to where we're not trying to figure out where we're going. We already know what the plan is. Yes. And I've been in touch with Falls County. They've been working, trying to work pretty hard to get people to help them over there and fill the jail up. And their interlocal agreement, I don't know if you compared it to what we have in Limestone County, but it's pretty close. One of the big issues for us is the transport, because of manpower. They're willing to transport to and from our facility when we notify them. That doesn't mean they're going to drop everything they're doing and come out in, but neither does Limestone County. It's when they need a chance to. The contractor will also transport to TBC if we need them to, as long as they're over there in their custody when the paperwork is all done. And it's $38 flat per minute.
And they do provide routine medical, which is the same
yes.
as our other contract. Mm-hmm. The only thing we'll need to find out from them is to be sure that they they do routine medical, non-prescription drugs.
Mm-hmm.
But if it's anything above that, they take them to a facility and they provide the guards.
They can,
they
or
can,
we can do
or
it.
We can. And mm-hmm. this, I was a little concerned. He said they do 2 guards.
That's what Limestone County does also.
And then they would charge us.
They would
that.
Charge us for that.
At time and
so depending on what we're looking at and what we're doing.
You could make that adjustment.
We,
to
yes.
work, we work better. Okay.
Right. Yeah. No, we wouldn't, just because it says they'll use 2 guards doesn't mean we're not going to send our own people over there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if we got 4 on shift and we feel like we can send one over there.
Just something I saw, I thought.
Yes.
On the indigent, on the medical, we need to have that discussion with them, and you might, hey, might want to have that discussion with them to be sure that anything that is billed medical, that is billed, that we pay on the indigent rate rather than the full. Most jails, I think, do that, but we had to, we had a little trouble getting that worked out for a little while with Limestone County.
Okay, all right, so check on the indigent rate on.
They pay indigent rates.
It's actually the Medicaid rate.
Medicaid rate, yes.
All right, so.
They should have an agreement with whoever they're using for their medical, that they accept the Medicaid rate rather than the full rate.
If not, we can get paid to talk to the judge over there.
And that's it, that's, okay, pay the Medicaid rate for any medical that was.
Yes.
Okay.
We will only be using.
Saves a lot of money.
We will only be using them if.
That's our secondary option.
This is just a backup plan in case Plan A.
And I wasn't even thinking about it until we, I'm not sure, until we ran into that issue. They said, we got two beds left, and I was like, oh boy. So we needed something.
Do you have a copy of that for us?
We can get one.
Okay.
So run copies of this?
Yes, we'll need one for the auditor's office and one for the county clerk.
Okay. And we're not gonna enter any local agreement until we find out about the Medicaid. Gotcha.
Let me ask you, I might have been asleep when you said it. So the $38 is the same that we pay over in Brooklyn?
Yes, Limestone County, it's $42 a person.
For the first 10.
For the first 10. And then it's $38 after. This is just $38 flat.
Tom, will you have, this zone two, we have a river swift we use?
We don't have an agreement at all except for Limestone County.
Okay, well, we did with.
You did with Henderson for a while, they won't transport.
In Jasper County?
I'm not sure about Jasper.
I don't remember that.
Only one I remember is.
We had an agreement with them.
Only one I remember is Henderson, and we ran into a lot of issues with transport.
I think we could probably approve that and then get the indigent part worked out.
I'm gonna do it with that being done.
Yeah. And it may take a little work to get that done if they're not doing it already, but we can.
Well, we'll get on that today when we leave here.
We have a motion?
I'll make a motion. With that being done, before you go into effect.
I second that.
Have a motion, second, all in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? None, motion carried.
And I'll notify the judge upon getting that worked out.
Item number seven is a request to refund $8,000 to the sheriff's office budget due to some bills that were paid on the different bills.
Yes, we've spent 66% of our allocated budget in our maintenance fund, in our maintenance line item, because of one bill that came from 2015 that wasn't paid, and two bills that came from July of 2016 that wasn't paid. And all three of those bills came out of the 2017 budget, and that's 66% of my allocated funds in that line item. I mean, when it started with $12,000, that's $8,000. And I have two vehicles that are down right now that I can't even pay to fix. One of them being the one I'm driving. So we're playing musical cars right now with six people. One being because of cameras, but and he's driving his own personal vehicle. So we're just trying to figure out, well, we'd like to get those funds back, obviously. They should have came out of the other budgets. I'm not going to get into why not they didn't, but we have to pay the bills. And these people contacted me and said their bills had never been paid. They give their bills to certain people. Nothing was ever done. And so when I took office, I made sure they got the bills paid because that's what we're supposed to do.
And they have already been paid.
They have been paid, correct?
Yes, but anytime something like that happens, you really do want to look at the cost.
cause, what happened, because these are significant dollars for the sheriff's office. So I at least went back to the auditor's office and determined that our date stamp shows that they were received past the point which we cut off the budget years for those prior. They were received in fiscal year 17. So we paid them when we got them, which was 17. So I'm not sure what happened before that, but I just...
The issue isn't the auditor's office. Let me make that clear. The issue with our office, for whatever reason, the bills weren't turned in.
A bill for 2015 didn't get to us till 17?
And that bill was worth, that bill cost us $4,108.
Who was it from?
It was a vehicle maintenance that was done at Fleet Pro back in 2015 on a vehicle that, I guess they...
Was it a rent?
I think it was a vehicle that had a lot of issues, and they took it up there. I'm not the one who made the decision on this. I'm just talking about what I know. They took it up there, had it fixed, and three times since they had it fixed, they contacted certain individuals to get it paid. It was never paid. And the last conversation ended up with a cussing match and hanging up. So when he came to me with it, obviously he did the work. Whether we needed the work done or not, he did the work, and we, you know, we had to pay him. So, and it's one of the vehicles we're actually using right now that I think has 212,000 miles on it.
Yeah, I don't have a problem to take care of that, but if we're going to do that, I'm going to need that $4,000 back in that lawsuit that I had to settle, and then I had to settle a bill that we didn't know anything about, another $2,000, so we're going to do that. I'm going to put on there that I need a refund on the money that they owe to me for past budgets. Because the lawsuit should have been settled way before I got here.
Are you talking about that Aramark?
That's correct.
It wasn't actually a lawsuit.
Well, it should have been taken care of way before I got here. With the last administration before that, that was not my bill. And so that bill should have came out of the budget several years ago, eight years ago. Aramark should have been taking care of that $4,000. So if we're going to do that, then I'm going to go back and get the money that is in precinct 3 as well.
Okay, we'll have that on the agenda.
We'll put it on the next agenda.
Okay, we'll put it on the next agenda for discussion. And will you give that to my husband?
I will.
So basically, I'm asking that we get refunded some of this money in order to get our at least two vehicles fixed. And we're 66% of the budget, a lot of money out of that line item that we're getting.
And where are we gonna get the money from?
Contingency special.
Contingency special.
We're out of contingency. We will have it will be replenished once the grant check gets here. But the grant check's not here right now. So that one is then completely depleted at this point. And now we're into contingency special.
I know my truck itself is going to cost nearly $700. It's been sitting in energy for 2 weeks. I put it off, but our vehicles aren't going to make it. $212,000 and $181,000, that's our extra vehicles, and they're getting ran 8 to 10 hours a day. They're not going to make it very long.
I make a motion we take it out of special, contingency special.
I second that.
All favor, aye.
Aye. Mm-hmm.
It's actually more than $8,000. I just rounded it off to a nice number.
Thank you.
All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carried.
Judge Grant, because I'm going to have to do a budget transfer, can we set a specific dollar amount?
That is it.
$8,000?
Item number 8.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Be approved, precinct rooms, sale of equipment, and there's a list of those. Zero turn lawnmower, a boom, axe tractor, another tractor, and a shredder.
I have two of each one of these, and we don't need those. We have a brand new boom axe, brand new tractor, and that's just sitting there. So we just need to go ahead and clean all of that up and put that money back where we can use it into the road.
And what will that cost this week? If we just approve to sell, then you'll put it out on wheels. And then if it doesn't sell, then if you want to do a bid, that would be open enough that you can use whatever means are best to sell that equipment. Is that correct?
There are two methods. We can do gov deals, which is the website. You can go and look at surplus government equipment that is for sale. The other is to go to the local newspapers and advertise and ask for sale dates.
The next question, can we do both of them, or do we need to do one at a time?
Well, I'm saying this motion, if it is approved the way that we have had it written here, would allow you to do either one without having to come back to court. So then you can decide which method you want to use. Do we have a motion?
I've got a question on that. Yes. What if somebody from the county wants to buy it? Another real great question.
Well, depending on how we decided to market those items, if they wanted it and we had it on the website, they'd have to go out to the website. If it was sealed bid, it would be advertised in the newspaper. We advertise the gov deals in the newspaper too. Then they would submit their sealed bid.
Or if somebody and Road Bridge wanted whatever the bid was, the top bid, we could just buy it for that instead of bid on.
So again, I didn't quite follow.
Well, just like they turn in bids on whatever.gov or in the paper, whatever the highest bid, could it be offered to other Road and Bridge departments for that money?
We.
If they can bid on it just like the commissioner, determines the way that they want to dispose of the equipment, the method, and then the other road and bridges, they can bid on it too.
Well, could we not, if somebody bid on it from somewhere, some company bid on it, and we got here to the thing, and they bid a certain amount on it, could we not reject that bid and then sell it to somebody, sell it to precinct three?
That I don't know. I'd have to ask.
But if we're talking about selling,
well, we got the option on. We got the option of selling or not selling it on. Mm-hmm.
But if you can determine what the fair market value is, then it could be offered to another department before you put it on good deals or on. If you can determine what the fair market value is.
I don't think that'd be very fair to bidders.
Well, but that's why I'm saying sell. If they did that before you put it out on another means for selling would be the best procedure probably, to try to make your deal before it goes out for open bids. All right, on that one.
So one commissioner owns the equipment and the other commissioner could buy it. But didn't the county pay for it once already?
I don't understand.
I don't either.
Well, it's not really all in one pot. Each one of you has your
budget
pot.
Each one has a budget.
Yeah, but the county already paid for it once, so wouldn't they have to pay for it all over again?
That money would stay within the county and just go to his precinct. Yeah. If you don't have equipment, he'd have the money to do something else for it.
Ah, see, yeah. Okay, yeah. I see what you're saying.
There's different funds.
It's a little different than
I was like, part. Are we buying it twice? Yeah. All right, I see what you're saying.
May I ask a question or make a comment? Could you not put on the agenda such as sell to precinct number two for X amount of money? Instead of not even just asking right now, no action, could you possibly say Commissioner Precinct 3 is requesting to sell this equipment to this precinct for this amount of money? And not go out.
I don't know.
I think that's what we're discussing. establishing a fair market value and then being able to transfer from one department to the other and the funds to that department to make it fair before we go out for bids.
I mean, that would be the easiest. I would, if you're asking my opinion, I would look into it to make sure that's complying with all the boxes we need to check to make sure it does. But if that's what's about to happen, then it seems like if that's an avenue that we can pursue, then that would be the easiest way to go about it.
And by saying sell, I think that would mean the one commission, one precinct to the other would be the same as selling it outright to other entities. Or do we need to put another little word in there that would make that? Sell or transfer?
I mean, like I said, I would have trouble giving a final opinion as I sit here right now to make sure that we're hitting the right.
I'm not touching it either.
Hitting the right words.
I would say we'll go forward with this. If we need other wording, then we can always come back to have that approved. Mm-hmm. But if you're talking about selling, I would think that would cover. But if not, you can let us know.
Yes,
is
ma'am.
This a hypothetical question, or do we actually have a commissioner that wants to buy some of this?
Well, I think it just got it.
It's not this. Depends on what it sells for.
Okay.
Well, you won't know if we do it upfront. We can just find out what the fair market value is, and then you can determine.
Yeah, that's the reason I'd like to look at the bids and go from there. We have the right to reject or accept any of those bids. And when we, if we do reject it, I can turn around or hand to turn around and buy the piece of equipment. Well, then we can.
I'm not sure that that's quite ethical to do it that way. I think we need to do that up front. I know. Think about it. Do you want us to table this here with the...
I would like for us just to go forward and then look at the other options while we're going forward.
Yeah, and then if you figure out what they can do.
Yeah, now we can figure out.
We need to put something back on. Have a special meeting to get that amended where we can do that. We have a motion.
Okay, is the motion from number three?
Yes, and it is to sell the
Let me ask you this because I want to make sure I don't have a problem. Now, I don't want to be making a motion since it's my precinct that is sold, so that there can be no problem. So I'm wondering if one of the other commissioners could make that motion. And then maybe I abstain from it since it's coming out of my precinct. Would that be a problem? I just want to make sure that I don't want to make a motion and then I look in the paper and someone saying, well, Mike Daniel made a motion on his own equipment. So I want to make sure that someone else, I would feel more comfortable with someone else would make that a motion.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, you withdraw
your
second.
I'll withdraw my second.
Do we have a motion?
I'll make a motion that we approve Commissioner Precinct 3 to be able to sell the equipment that's listed here today.
We have a second.
Second.
All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? None. Motion carried. Item number 9, we do not have any volunteer fire department agreements. Item number 10, burn ban. What are you thinking back there?
We're good. We're issuing life jackets now, so. you know, it's kind of, the thing is, we need to close watch because it will stop raining and the sun will come out and the wind will blow and this ryegrass on the side of the highways and all this winter rides will still out there is going to die. And it will get feisty real quick.
But
we're good now. Yes.
Any other discussion from anyone? If not, we'll go to item number 11, special road use agreements, contracts, permits, and bonds. Does anybody have one? All right. If not, then we will go to item number 12, bonds and education certificates of county officials and employees. Do we have any? None. Then, are there any comments from commissioners or members?
I'd like to say one thing. First of all, thank you very much, because that's been a chaotic situation down there with us and vehicles for every shift, every day. But I also wanted to point out we had $67 left in that account. So we didn't even have enough to buy a package if we needed one. So we appreciate it very much.
Well, the volunteer fire department is having their annual barbecue on the first Saturday of May. I believe that's correct. If not, I think we But I think that's for it.
Did you have anything for?
No, ma'am.
All right, if not, we are adjourned.